Sri Krishna, the personality of Godhead, who is the Paramatma, Supersoul, in everyone's heart and the benefactor of all the truthful devotees, cleanses the desire for material enjoyment from the heart of the devotee who relishes his messages, which are in themselves virtuous when properly heard and chanted.
Sri Krishna, the Paramatma, Supersoul, in everyone's heart and the benefactor of all the truthful devotees, cleanses the desire for material enjoyment from the heart of the devotee who relishes his messages, which are in themselves virtuous when properly heard and chanted. Sunidam Sarvabhutam Vyartamam Shanti. This is the way of Shanti. Shanti means peaceful. How is it? Not by this peace treaty. That kind of Shanti or peace is going on perpetually. Never Shanti. It is simply for marriage. Shanti cannot be attained without Krishna consciousness, peacefulness. It is not possible. Temporarily, you can make some arrangement, but it has no value. Even among the relatives, father and the son, or husband and wife, brother and mother. There is no peace anywhere. There is some disagreement and separation. This is the law of the material world, not of the spiritual world. Spiritual world, there is something. The material world, envy. If you improve more than me, I become your enemy. This is the nature of influence. Therefore, the Bhagavatam, the cult of Srimad Bhagavatam, is not meant for the materialistic person. It is for the person he is spiritually interested. Spiritually interested means he is a Param Pumsa. Param means the supreme. And Pumsa, Pumsa means the swan. But Param Pumsa is supreme swan. What is the special qualification of the swan? That if you give the swan to drink milk mixed with water, it has got a special power. She drinks the milk portion and the water portion will not touch. Hamsa. And Paramhamsa means the person who knows what is the essence of this material world. It's called Param. Who knows. Just like we are a living entity. You have got your body, I have got my body, everyone has got his body. But what is the essence of this body? The essence of this body is in life. There is no life. You may have a very nice, beautiful body. I may have a very strong, beautiful body. But as soon as the life is gone, there is no life. Therefore, the essence of the body is in life. Similarly, this big gigantic body, cosmic manifestation. So there is also life. Otherwise, how it is when? Anyone can understand this philosophy. That this body is very important, belonging to certain cultures, personalities, scientists, thought, philosopher, politician, whatever it may be. But so long the life is. Otherwise, no more politician, no more scientist, no more businessman. Think that it is very simple to think, unless there is life within this cosmic manifestation, how things are going on so nicely. So, one who is interested with that essence of this gigantic cosmic manifestation, he is called Paramahansa. He is no more interested in any other. Active principle. What is the active principle? Just like medical science, they get active principle from a drug. Similarly, those are Paramahansa. They can understand that what is the active principle of this cosmic consciousness. There must be something. Must be something. There is no doubt. But one is interested to know. Therefore, in the beginning of the Srimad Bhagavatam, it is said, dharma prajjita koita vatra parama nirmasaranam satan bhaktava vastu jitamatra. Here in the Srimad Bhagavatam. So, with this idea, to become Paramahansa, or to understand the central point, because if you simply understand the central point, then everything is understood. That is Vedic injunction. Yasmin vijyate sarvamidam vijyatam bhavanti. If you simply understand Krishna, then everything becomes understood. It is so nice. Yasmin vijyate, by understanding the absolute truth, Krishna, sarvamidam vijyatam bhavanti, everything becomes understood. Just like one big scientist or disciple, Dr. Samur Sarup Damodar Das, M.S.C.H.D., he has dedicated his very advanced scientific book. He cannot even utter the words. Fatalities, fatalities, fatalities. So, he is a great scientist, admitted by many universities, Goward University, Calcutta University, here in Boston University, and then again California University. He is not ordinary. But he admits in his dedication that I dedicate this book to my spiritual master, because he has given me the real knowledge that Krishna is the only knowledge. Now, I am not a scientist, but I could teach a scientist a convincing that Krishna is the origin of it. Unless he is convinced that Krishna is the origin of everything, how is this? So many scientists will challenge him. How is he prepared to accept the challenge? So, how it was possible for me to convince a big scientist? And the fact is, as I stated, that if you understand Krishna, then you can teach even the greatest scientist, the greatest philosopher, the greatest politician, everything. That is it. It all depends departing at this time, but if you truly understand the song, then you will be able to teach in the British time. Let us fill the hall, let us anyone, let them come, we shall teach. We shall become their teacher. We get it. Why? Because we know little of it. There is a verse in the Bhagavad. Tathāpiti deva padāmbhujadvayam prasāda vishāna jīvita jīvita jānāti tattam. One devotee says, my dear Lord, one who has got a little fragmented grace of your lotus feet, he knows their feet. Tathāpiti deva padāmbhujadvayam prasāda vishāna jīvita jīvita jānāti tattam. Nacharnayipurvichirangvichar. A devotee of Krishna, he can understand the tattva of the soul. Simply, a little mercy, as the mercy of Krishna. Others, they may continue to speculate for many, many births. Therefore, Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Bhauram Janmanamanti Janavan Mam Prabhupada. Just like the scientist, yes, currently, his study of science is perfect. When one surrenders to Krishna, perfectly knowing well that Krishna is the origin of everything, that is the perfection of knowledge. In another place, I think in this chapter, you find, Padapumhi Vijasreshta Vannasama Vibhāra Sānuṣṭhitasya Dharmasya Samsiddhi Rito. Everyone is engaged in different occupation and duty. Whatever you mean. That one should be interested to know whether by executing this kind of duty, whether I am becoming perfect. But they have no satisfaction. Neither they do know what is perfection. A human life is meant for achieving perfection. That is the aim of life. So there are so many things that we must know that we, if we understand Krishna, his life in truth, then our life. Not that we cannot understand Krishna, he is so big and so unlimited. It is not possible. Krishna himself does not know how great. God is great, he says. When you trust God, how great is God? That is it. So, that greatness, you can understand Krishna, or Krishna's greatness, life after life, hearing the thousands and millions of years, it is remarkable. Ananta, Ananta name, is explaining about Krishna by ananta or unlimited basis. Now, unlimited now, he has got many sounds. He says he could not say. So that is not possible. But if you try to understand about Krishna, then Krishna will help you how to understand. Vrindavan Sabhagam Krishna. Krishna is so much. If anyone is interested to know about Krishna, to hear about Krishna, then Vrindavan Sabhagam Krishna, Vrindavana Kirtan. So Krishna, to know about Krishna, even if we do not understand, that. He simply chants Krishna Krishna actually here at night. Krishna 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 day. Krishna 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 Krishna. If you simply chant like that, you become part. Immediately you become part. Yes. Srinatam Sanatam Krishna. Puna Krishna means hearing and chanting means you become part. We are all simple. We are all material bodies. Anyone is living in this material. Must be considered simple. It is a question of feeling. Unless we are simple, there is no question of accepting this material body. Buddha, Buddha, Buddha. We are committing simple life. Therefore, next life we are getting a certain type of body. Everything is meant for both of us. Why different types of body? Why not the same body? No. Karanam kuna sanyayasa. Madasa yoni janma. Because we are associating with certain quality of material.
There are three qualities of material. Sattva, Rajas, Guna and Tama.
So one of them I must associate. One of them. So if we associate with Sattva, we get a different type of body. If we associate with Rajas, then we get a different type of body. If we associate with the tamagun, then we get a different type of body. This is the law of nature. Exactly like that. If you infect a certain type of disease, you get that. Nature's law. Cannot avoid. If you infect typhoid disease, then you must suffer from that. Similarly, we, during this living condition, Buddha, Buddha, Pradiyasa, we are, our position is that we are changing body after body and we are suffering according to the body. If we want to stop our suffering, then we must stop getting another material disease. And that you can do only by Krishna consciousness. Otherwise, maybe in the modes of goodness, that much. Here in the material world, you can elevate up to the modes of goodness. And what is the result of goodness? Uddham gacchati sattva. If you associate with goodness, then you can be promoted to the very, very high kind of good. There are Udham, Avam, and Mukh. The planet systems and world, therefore it is called three worlds. And there are some planet systems. Just like this Earth is called Bhurloka. It is situated in the middle. And above Earth, there are seven lokas. And down Earth, there are seven lokas. So, in this middle position, if we associate with goodness, then we can be promoted to the higher planetary system. Like Brahma has got, he has got very, very long duration of life. The standard of living in other planets, other planetary system is thousands times more comfortable. So you can get up. Udhanga Chanti Rajasa, you can be told. Madhya Tishanti Rajasa, if we associate with Rajagun, then you can remain in the middle position. And if you associate with Tamagun, then you go down. Just like here we see some of the animals are meant for being slaughtered. So, in previous life, they also scattered. Therefore, they are waiting to become, to be slaughtered. Mamsa is a Sanskrit word of meat. Mam means means me, Sha means he. I eat you this time, you eat me next time. This is called karma bandha. Jagyathe karma anatra lokam karma. Now we are very happy that we have got so much, so many living stocks. I shall kill one and eat, enjoy. And he does not know that he is making the path smooth, the theory of the peace. This is karma bandha. So, this is going on, bhutta bhutta praliyate. We are getting one type of body and eating or sleeping or making according to the body. There are so many hundred thousand. Eating, eating, sleeping, sex life and depending everywhere. Either an insect or a big man. Everyone knows how to eat, how to see, how to enjoy sex life. In his own way. That is not the real business of human life. Real business of human life is here mentioned. Sinnadam Sabadam. Just try to hear about it. We are opening so many centers. Just to give chance to people to hear about it. That's all. And if one hears, then a chance. Immediately he becomes beautiful, punna savana beautiful. And as much as the more you become beautiful, riddham tasa avadrani vidunati, then all the dirty things accumulated within the heart on account of contamination of this material earth, that becomes clean. And as soon as it is clean, you understand that you are eternally related with Krishna. He is the Supreme Master and we are servitor. Let us serve Krishna. That is perfect.